we hear the word. We lose ourselves, but we find it all. Cause we are the ones that wanna play. Always wanna go, but you never wanna stay. And wanna choose. Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose.
Aerials in the sky. Bam. All right. Well, that was the Varg skateboarding in Norway with the Boycott Israel shirt and the Boycott Israel flag. You've seen that intro. He doesn't like System of a Down, so I made System of the Down the song. Some of you younger people have asked, what is that music? It's System of a Down. I think the song is Aerials. I don't actually hear it when I play it every day. All the video I have has no sound anyway. We were supposed to have Adam Fitzgerald a couple days ago, right after the Four Horsemen. Of course, the Four Horsemen didn't happen because of just some crap on their end. So we had One Horseman instead. We will just reschedule that. This weekend, they're going down to the Ron Paul conference in Virginia, both Jackman and Reed. So, you know, nothing better than that. So I guess after that's 9/11, so I'm going to be busy. So I don't know. We'll do the Horsemen whenever we can. And because that got bumped, the Fitzgerald thing got bumped. And then he already had a commitment yesterday. You know, this week, all of us are in pretty high demand about explaining 9/11 stuff. So I thought it was going to be today. I think I got the time zone things right and stuff, and I called him on VK and also on Skype without an answer. So that's all right. We'll just do the regular news starting. Oh, there it is. He just got home. Cool. Well, let me just tell you real fast about Ukraine then. I'll call you in a second, Adam. Joe Biden, Mr. Magoo, has said he demanded Russia give unconditional surrender. The guy has no clue. Ukraine is losing the war on every measuring stick. They've lost territory. They've lost men. They've lost their core troops and their weapons. And winter's coming. Europe's being crippled by their own sanctions. And he said, yeah, give up now. Total surrender or else. Who is this dude surrounded by? Kamala Harris, she's a vapid airhead, knows nothing, but who's telling him this? Blinken? Newland? Who's giving him all this bad info, and why doesn't he just know on his own? Unbelievable. So Joe Biden's a tool. Okay, Adam's here, so I'm going to pop on over to record stuff with him. Not going to do it live, because, let me explain why, and don't be mad. I feel like we're going to go over so many names and things that he knows that I know, but it'd be really great if we could slide in some documents like this is where this is coming from. This is how you know this. So I thought I'd be better to edit it and not have, Shekel chats and stuff interrupting, even though I do like making money. I just feel like 9/11 is too important. So not that you have bad questions. But some of you do. I swear to God, if someone says we're their airplanes, I don't have the energy. What happens is you end up on everlasting defense if you have to handhold people. Like, we're just going to explain what happened. Not going to waste time debunking kook theories. I mean, you can figure it out. Like, if you don't have hijackers in planes, then there's no paper trail to anything. So, we'll see you. I will see you in a bit. I'm going to have him on. I'm going to record it, and then I'm going to already know probably what documents we're going to use, and I'm going to put that all together and put it out tomorrow. So, see you then. I do have the documents. Somebody says Rye's got the documents. I've had the documents for a long time. Also tomorrow, a film release. Three in a row. So Thursday, Friday, Saturday, we'll be releasing films. Thanks mostly to two mega donors and everybody else that contributed to the campaign. So that's going to be on How Terrorists Formed a Nation, the Parasite film, as well as What's Keeping Africa Down. And all three important, all three different, and all three about to be free. Yankee Carpetbagger just slammed in 25 and says, what's your favorite vintage Shuto matchup? Oh, hell. It's not really my favorite, but a nice thing that everybody needs to see is that match with Cho and Don Fry, where it's just a whole bunch of head punches. That one's pretty based. Old vintage Shuto match. Shit. There's too many, man. There's a lot of great ones. I don't know. I'd have to think about it. I can't do that off the top of my head. That's like saying, what's your favorite pro wrestling match ever? I don't know. For a while, it was Savage Steamboat. But when I say mega donors, you know what I mean. I'm being facetious. Major donors. Mega's the wrong word, for sure. We're not part of the mega group here. I mean, I exposed the mega group. No one even knew what that meant. I was like, that's the mega donors. And it's Wexler and these boys. The only people that reported on that hardly at all was LaRouche. And then ended up going down the wrong path and getting the wrong conclusions. I guess Raimondo kind of wrote about a different mega when he was talking about the Wiseman-Roseman scandal, where AIPAC was being sued and revealed classified information on Iran and all that. That's in my first book, by the way. Welcome to USSA. Yes, if I hear anything about mini nukes, space beams, or thermite smoothies, I'm going to throw the computer out the window. And I know Adam's heard it all too, but I've been dealing with this crap for 21 years, and God, I hate it. I hate Loose Change and Alex Jones, and they kookified the whole thing. Yeah, Intergalactic Clockwork Elves, or whatever he's on to now. It's something else. We have a nice rant from Telegram last night. I'll throw that up on Substack. So let me bounce off of here and call Adam, and we'll see you tomorrow. I'll see you in a few hours on Telegram. Peace.